My dear Snodgrass, how can I write when you keep making all that noise? You're putting me off.
Sorry, Mr. Hooter. I keep thinking I'm going to sneeze.
And do blow your nose instead of sniffing like that.
I can't. I haven't got a hanky.
I'll go and get one of mine.
That's no good. I wouldn't be able to use it.
Why not?
Well, I haven't got any hands. To hold it with.
That does make things rather difficult.
Achoo!
Poof! Bless you! Here we are then. Oh, what's that?
It's Mr. Hooter's diary.
It's more like a book to me.
A diary is a book. It's a book that you write in every day.
Oh, what do you write in it?
Oh, all sorts of things. Things you've done, ideas you've had, things you're going to do, and things that you've seen.
Oh, can I look at what you've written?
But my diary's private. That means that I'm the only one who's supposed to see it.
Oh, go on, let me see. I expect you've written something really clever and really interesting.
Well,
Snodgrass seems to have a cold. Well, that really is interesting, Mr. Hooter. Have you got a cold, Snodgrass?
No, I don't remember a cold. No, I don't think it's a cold, Toby.
Of course it's a cold. You've been sneezing and sniffing all morning. If that's not a cold, what is it?
Hay fever.
Hay fever? What's that?
Well, it's a bit like a cold because you sneeze a lot and your eyes run. I usually get hay fever when somebody's been cutting grass.
Ah, the magician's been cutting the grass today, and he left a big pile of grass cuttings next to the gazebo.
Well, that's what's caused my hay fever.
Ah. Good morning, everybody. Aren't they wonderful? Ah, what it is to be a great magician and a great gardener. Music.
Look at my garden, begging your pardon, but isn't my garden the best you've ever seen? Leaves are growing, blossoms are showing, and the grass I've been mowing is as green, the bushes are neat, the flowers smell sweet, and even the beet hoots the best there's ever been. You can keep all the rest, I can stick out my chest, 'cause this is the best looking garden to be seen.
Don't you think so, Toby?
Well, it's not bad.
Not bad?
Apart from the pile of grass cuttings.
He's got hay fever, you see, magician. He keeps sneezing and sniffing because of that grass.
Oh, I am sorry. Well, we'd better get rid of it then, hadn't we? Come on.
What are you going to do with it?
I'm not sure.
Why don't we burn it?
Oh, no. It might set fire to the gazebo.
Mr. Hoot is right, Toby. Not only that, there might be some little creatures in there.
Oh. Oh, there is something. Ah, it's Maple. Maple, what are you doing in there?
Oh, just having a little nap. Hello, everybody.
It's a good job we didn't set fire to that grass.
Yes, it would have been very dangerous. You know, I seem to remember that the Iron Boy and the Sandalwood Girl had to run away from a fire in the grass.
Ah, did they? Was that an adventure they had in the country of Zorn?
Yes, it was. Do you want to hear about it?
I certainly would, yes.
Well, let's go and see what we can see in the bird bath. Now, you remember that the Iron Boy and the Sandalwood Girl were trying to find the Silver River in the Blue Mountains?
Yes, because if they bathed in the river, they'd become a real girl and boy.
That's right, but their journey was very dangerous. Oh.
The Iron Boy and the Sandalwood Girl stood on a hill in the magical country of Zorn. Look, cried the Iron Boy, look! He pointed toward the Blue Mountains. That's the way we must go. There's a river in the valley, said the Sandalwood Girl. Let's take this little path down to the river. They went down the path through the tall, dry grass which covered the sides of the valley. They hadn't gone far when they saw a hare sitting at the side of the path. Who are you? Asked the hare. An Iron Boy and a girl made of sandalwood, said the Iron Boy. We're going to the Blue Mountains to look for the Silver River. Don't be afraid. We won't hurt you. You're going on a very dangerous journey, said the hare. Don't you know that fire dragons live in the valley? If they see you, they'll set fire to the grass. I'm not afraid of fire, said the Iron Boy. I'm made of iron. And iron doesn't burn. But I'm made of wood, cried the Sandalwood Girl. Wood burns in a fire. We must find another path, said the Iron Boy. This is the way to the Blue Mountains, said the Hare. We must try and find another way, said the Iron Boy. But as they turned back, they saw smoke behind them. It's too late, cried the Hare. Quick, this way. The fire dragons have set fire to the grass. Run down to the river and hide under the water. They began to run. But as they ran down the path, a big red fire dragon stepped out in front of them. A great flame shot out of the dragon's mouth, and the grass began to burn. As quick as a flash, the Iron Boy picked up the Sandalwood Girl and held her high up above his head. The fire dragon sent another burst of fire rolling towards them, but the Iron Boy ran past him down towards the river. They got to the river just in time. It was wide and shallow, and they waded across to some big rocks in the middle and sat down with the water all around them. The grass flamed along the riverbank like a wall of fire, but the Iron Boy and the Sandalwood Girl were safe in the middle of the river.
Oof! They were lucky to escape from that fire. But it couldn't reach them while they were in the middle of the river, could it?
Oh, no. The water would put the fire out.
Was that the Silver River?
Oh, no. They had quite a few more adventures before they reached the Silver River. And we can hear another one of them next time. Still, we've got this one to be going on with. What's it called?
The Fire in the Grass. Ah. I think I've got it in the gazebo. Let's go and see.
Right.
If I read my book here, would it disturb you, Mr. Hooter?
Not at all.
Good. Right. Now we want fire in the grass.
No, we don't. It will be very dangerous.
Oh, no, Maple. That's the title of the book I'm looking for.
Oh, that's all right then.
Yes, right. There it is. Look. Fire in the grass.
Ah, yes, you're right. Fire in the grass. Let's see. Well,
The Iron Boy and the Sandalwood Girl were going towards the river when they met someone.
Don't tell me. It was a hare.
Correct. And here she is. She gave them a warning.
Yes. She told them that fire dragons lived in the valley. They were going to turn back, but they saw lots of smoke behind them.
The dragons had set fire to the grass, so the Iron Boy and the Sandalwood Girl were in danger of being burned.
There was only one thing they could do. Oh, look, it says there. Run, cried the Iron Boy.
Yes, they ran and ran, and then something stepped out in front of them.
It was a fire dragon. Oh, look at this picture of him. Mm. Doesn't he look fierce?
Yes, I wouldn't like to meet him. Still, the Iron Boy and the Sandalwood Girl managed to get past him, and they ran on until they reached the river.
Just shows you what can happen when you set fire to things.
Mm.
So we'd better not set fire to the grass cuttings. But what are we going to do with them? We'll have to get rid of them, or poor Snodgrass will be sneezing all day.
Yes, please get rid of it.
I will. I'll magic it away.
Where to?
Well, it doesn't really matter, does it? So long as I magic it out of the garden. Come on, Toby, let's go and cast a spell.
Oh, righto. Right, what do we need first?
Well, it's grass we want to get rid of, so we need something beginning with G.
G. G.
G.
G. What about glove? That glove?
Oh, yes. It's one of my old gardening gloves.
Oh, well, that's two G's, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Gardening glove.
Oh, yes.
That should make it a very good spell.
Yes, here you are, Barrel.
Thank you kindly.
Don't mention it. Now, we need a colour, and we want to get rid of the grass, so we need a colour beginning with R for rid.
R for rid, and R for red, a red rose.
Splendid. Here you are, Barrel, a red rose, especially for you.
Thank you. It will need water, of course, otherwise it will shrivel up.
Thirsty again, eh?
That's better. Now the tune for this spell goes... Bom, 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 bom.
Thank you, Barrel. Right, all together then.
Bom, 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 bom. Now, clap that magic clap.
Here goes. And now, the magic rhyme. Puddle, muddle, muddle, puddle. Pile of grass makes Snodgrass sneeze. Muddle, puddle, puddle, muddle. Move it from our garden, please.
Ooh.
Splendid, it's gone. Now let's have a cup of tea.
Oh, where do you think the pile of grass has gone?
Who cares? It doesn't really matter, does it? Magician, put the kettle on. Magician, put the kettle on. Magician, put the
kettle... I wonder where that pile of grass has gone.
Oh, don't worry about it. Here. Have a biscuit.
I'd still like to know, you know.
Look, it doesn't really matter. It could be anywhere.
Thank you.